Dear friends and colleagues, welcome back to the Mangano Digital Academy and welcome back to the essential of digital dentistry. In this lecture, I will talk to you about the combined computer tomography and the importance of this powerful device for diagnosis. As we know, digital dentistry is essentially based on four steps, and the data acquisition, the acquisition of 3D data from the patient, from the real world to the virtual world, is very important because it's the first step and it's essential to capture reliable 3D images of our patient in order to virtualize the patient in the virtual world inside the different softwares. We have computer assisted design software for prosto, for ortho, for surgery, and we need to use this software having proper data to manage, and the data given by combined computer tomography, intraoral scanner, face scanner, digital condylography, they can be, all together composed in order to create our virtual patient. So after the virtualization of the patient, we can then plan our restoration, for example, in prostodontics, our crown, our bridges, our surgical guidance surgery, our orthodontic devices, and then we can fabricate them, moving from the virtual again to the real, thanks to milling unit, 3D printers, laser sintering machine, laser melting machine. And then we have the clinical application. And this is the essence of digital dentistry. These are the essence of digital dentistry. And combined computer tomography play a very important role because it's one game changer for the clinic, for the clinicians. Today we talk about the diagnosis and the powerful, because combined computer tomography is a powerful tool for diagnosis. And when we talk about diagnosis, we talk about, first of all, the limits with the conventional two-dimensional radiology. Because panoramic radiograph and oral radiograph are bidimensional representation, so 2D representation of the 3D worlds, of 3D anatomical structures. And as a consequence, they suffer from distortion, alteration, superimposition, subtraction, and also artifacts. So our diagnostic potential is very limited with the two-dimensional radiology. And we have to consider that for many, many years, all the dentists have made their diagnosis based on the clinical evidence and the 2D radiology. But now we have combined computer tomography. We have this tool that is changing and revolutionizing the world of dentists. In fact, it's spreading all around the world, and now we can see, we can find this machine in almost all the dental offices for the digital dentists in particular. Why CBCT is so important? Because CBCT gives us the possibility to obtain a better diagnosis. For example, in endodontics, we can perfectly localize in 3D periapical lesion. We can evaluate complex endodontic anatomy. We can make a proper diagnosis of radicular resorption, of perforation, or even tooth fracture, radicular fracture. In dental traumatology as well is very important because we can find very clearly where the dental fracture have occurred, or bone traumas, traumatic lesion for the bone. In perio is as well very important because it can help us to diagnosis for the diagnosis of bone lesion, periodontal diseases. We can also evaluate the anatomy, that is also very important for oral surgery. For example, when we have to remove wisdom teeth, or in general impacted teeth, when we have situation like cyst, or benign or malignant lesion, and also when we have to see, evaluate where structure like the inferior vernal nerve or the maxillary sinus are in relation with our treatment. For example, when we plan our implant surgery, we need to evaluate very well where to place our implant. We need to understand if there is a sufficient amount of bone in terms of height and thickness, and we need to to see the distance is the relationship between our planning and the unviolable anatomical structure, like, for example, the nerve. But also in orthodontics is very important, and it will become a game changer very soon, because we have the possibility to evaluate, for example, the position of the root for the orthodontic purpose. So combi computed tomography has a different possible application for diagnosis. And now I give you a few examples of the power of this machine. This is a young male, 39 years old, who came to our office for a trauma of the anterior teeth in general, but particularly the central incisor, left central incisor. And we made this evaluation with our CS9300, and we saw that, I mean, from the 2D evaluation, this is the 2D representation of an endoral radiograph, and we don't see nothing in particular. There's no evidence of, it's not possible to make a proper diagnosis only with the 2D, with this periapical radiograph. But if we watch what happened with the combined computed tomography, we see very well that we had a fracture. In fact, there was a fight in the disco, and after the fight of the disco, this is the situation, because there was a traumatic bone and a traumatized bone, and the situation is pretty clear. We need to immediately stabilize the tooth in order to save also and to preserve the bone as much as possible, because the tooth apex is displaced outside the socket after the trauma. And this is after 1 year after the treatment, as we can see. Of course, there was a loss of bone, but the stability of the soft tissues clinically was very good after the treatment. Basically, the tooth was repositioned correctly and devitalized. So with the 2D, we have difficulties when we have to pose the proper diagnosis. With 3D, everything is much easier, and also the treatment plan is well defined. This is another case for perio. We have a bone lesion. In this case, the patient came to our office because she had some problem in another office. They placed an implant in the anterior mandible, and this implant was too close to the natural teeth, and so the implant was lost, the periodontal ligament was damaged, and also there was a big lesion, and the patient came with infection and pain. So we simply made a combined computed tomography in order to evaluate the situation. This was the situation, with a very big lesion in the bone, affecting also the teeth that were neighboring the implant. The implant had been removed already, but the situation didn't improve, and there was the need to make a second surgery in order to clean the area and to re-establish a physiological situation. And then a third surgery was needed for the restoration of the anatomy through bone regeneration. As we can see here, these large bone defects are very easy to diagnose with the combined computed tomography. It's very difficult to understand the topology and also the anatomy of the defect without a 3D examination. So it was clearly an advantage. Here another example from this panoramic radiograph. It's very difficult to make a proper diagnosis. We have this lesion in the mandible. Maybe there was strong pain. So what kind of lesion is this? We don't trust absolutely the 2D radiograph in this case. There's a need of a 3D examination. And with combined computed tomography, everything becomes very clear. We are talking about a lithiasis of the salivary gland, and the position was absolutely not in the mandible. It was quite far of the mandible, but the superimposition that we have with 2D radiographs made not possible to clearly pose a diagnosis. So the best way in order to put the diagnosis in this case to use combined computed tomography. So the pain of the patient was related to this condition, the lithiasis of the salivary gland. Another example of how valuable is combined computed tomography for diagnosis is the case of wisdom teeth or impacted teeth, particularly when we have to remove difficult impacted teeth. In this case, we have a 28, a third molar in the maxilla, And we can see that with this kind of software, we can immediately evaluate in 3D the position of the tooth in order to plan at best our surgery. And the point is that, yes, we can see the relation, for example, with the maxillary sinus in the different multiplanar reconstructions. And it's also very interesting to see the rendering because with the 3D rendering, we are capable to really understand and to fully understand the real position of the crown, the real position of the root. In relation of our other anatomical structure, and we can plan at best the surgery, and we can consider the risk that we can have during the intervention and during the surgery itself. We can see how the roots are positioned also inside the maxillary sinus, for example, so we can navigate inside our patient, and it's a big advantage that we don't have, of course, with conventional limited 2D b-dimensional radiographs. And here we can see how the crown look like from behind, so from the inside of the oral cavity of the patient, and exactly how the tooth is positioned. It's a major advantage when we make surgery because we can approach the tooth correctly with the proper, I mean, approach, and we can the surgery can be easier and faster, of course. And also, you can find sometimes some incidental, also, you can pose also incidental diagnosis because this patient, the same patient, had a lesion in this case on the first molar and she didn't know about it and we could notice it properly with the same examination, with the same CBCT scan. Again, wisdom tooth, in this case, we are talking about two wisdom teeth in the left and in the right mandible. And the position of the inferior alveolar nerve in this case was very close, so we need to consider that it's absolutely important. I think it's mandatory in this case before to extract, to approach this difficult teeth, it's absolutely mandatory to obtain a CBCT scan of the patient. It's absolutely something that is mandatory also for legal issues. I think it's quite important to avoid to have problems during the surgery and after the surgery. And as we can see here, there is a very close relationship between the inferior alveolar nerve and the roots of this tooth. So the strategy and the way we approach the tooth during the surgical act, during the intervention change as the position of the tooth and the relationship between the roots of the tooth and the inferior alveolar nerve change. So we need to adapt to the different anatomical situation. We need to see exactly where the inferior alveolar nerve is. And with this tool, with this device, with this software, we can really facilitate our surgery because we can see the position of the nerve in relation of the anatomical structure, the bone, the tooth, and we can prevent every possible complication during the surgery because we really know in 3D where the inferior alveolar nerve is, where it's located, and the relationship with the roots. It's very important. So, from these very short examples, just a collection of few cases, we understood properly that combined computer tomography is an essential instrument that cannot be missing in the modern dental practice, as it represents an extremely valuable tool for diagnosis in almost all dental fields. I show here in this short lecture some perio case, some surgical case, some endo case. The CBCT is essential for diagnosis, but at the same time, it is not only an essential tool for diagnosis. It's also a game changer for our treatment plans because we can export the DICOM files from the CBCT and we can import these files into different software. For example, in guided surgery, we can import these DICOM files into a guided surgery software like the one I use, SMOP, for designing surgical guidance, but also meshes or scaffold for bone regeneration and more. I will show you more in one of the next lectures. So, the point is diagnosis, of course, that is the basis for everything, the basis for all treatment planning, but also the impact of the combined computer tomography as a game changer because we can also use the images from combined computer tomography to design a series of tools, a series of devices that are very helpful in our, I mean, practice. So thank you very much for your kind attention, and don't forget to write me if you want to tell me something, to comment on the lecture, or to contact me for some questions, because I'm here. Thank you.